Hello everyone, I Anjali from Chitkara School of Hospitality welcome you in this e-learning session. In today's topic, we will be talking about teamwork and leadership. So starting with the teamwork, the current trend in a housekeeping operation is to form team to accomplish tasks rather than scheduling employee on an individual basis. Managing a large workforce, as is found in the most housekeeping department in a hotel, is a big challenge for the executive housekeeper. The three important determinants of the teamwork and a leadership are the building of a right kind of a group. A housekeeping team may consist of one supervisor, several 2 to 5 GRAs, and one houseman. This team under the supervisors become totally responsible for a particular section of a guest room in a hotel. Cleaning performance, say, is then measured on a team basis rather than an individual basis. And building of a right kind of a group will help to lead towards the goal or a target. Second one is better productivity. Of course, when there is a teamwork with a perfection, definitely the better productivity is going to be achieved. The third one is membership, which is very much important as being a team member. Promoting teamwork. When we talk about the teamwork, and it is very much important to promote a teamwork, the executive housekeepers should know and should understand how it needs to take an efficient step to promoting a teamwork. Promoting teamwork within each team is required a specific effort. A teamwork checklist, which involves the reward of a teamwork by praising the team, which is very important to an executive housekeeper while promoting a teamwork. The reward has to be done on the daily basis or not on a daily basis, though it can be of a monthly basis, where a team leader or a executive housekeeper can always praise his or her team after doing a particular task. Second one is including teamwork work criteria during the appraisal. When there's a time of appraisal, it is very much important that whatever, wherever the teamwork which was going to end success would be written down and that particular of appraisal time. Rotate special assignment, which is important for promoting a teamwork. Share information about the team so that they will understand about the all concepts about the housekeeping or about the hotel. Give credit well job done by an employee. If it working on a team also or individual also, it will help to promote a teamwork. Set an example of a cooperation with other yourself. That is also important for promoting a teamwork. The next one is advantage of a teamwork. Cooperation and a worker morale will be higher if the teamwork will be there, and a team spirit will also be gained against people who are working in a team. There will be no absenteeism and a tiredness if the person who is working on a team. Safety and security will be maintained. There will be a create of a fun when working on a team and doing a task in a team. For example, a cleaning of a room with entire teamwork will have a creation of a fun, and the employee will love to perform with the team. Fewer tools will be needed while working in a team. Some heavier tasks are accomplished more easily when we are working in a team. It has been looked upon that more of the heavier task which is working may be more accomplished, and it becomes more easier while working in a team. Standard becomes more easier, or the following of SOPs will be more easier. The people will able to follow the SOPs regarding as in teamwork is concerned. Saving of a labor cost, definitely there will be a less number of a saving. There will be a saving with of a labor cost will be developed. Advantage to the manager, as when a team working with a team will give a perfect perfection and will make the work easily done, and the work will be done on a time. That will be a great advantage for a manager. The second topic, that is a leadership. For a teamwork in a housekeeping to be a successful, the department leader, that is the executive housekeeper, needs to be an inspiring role model as a team player as well as an efficient leader. The leader of any group can help to build its member into a well-knit team by sharing vision, goals, strategies with them. Leadership is a capacity to frame plans that will succeed and the faculty to pursue other to carry out in the face of difficulties. Leadership quality in a manager makes a people look up to him or her advice, feel motivated towards the work and respect the manager and to be loyal to the manager. So then executive housekeeper who can be mobilized the trust and the support of the staff achieving a great height. So it's very much important to be a, when you are working in a teamwork, the leadership also plays an important, and that needs to be done by the EHK so that they can be, he or she can be the inspiring model for all of his workers. The good leader ensures the following activities. That involves, it draft a compiling vision, it communicate passionately, it get cooperation from other, and it also inspire and pull employees towards the goal. When there is a good team leader, it will help to learn from the other leaders as well. It will be helping for making a decision in a line and with the vision. It will give a good feedback and it will help to command and not demand respect and loyalty. And it will do also help when a leader is doing a self-evaluation, that will be also help, and it will also prove a good leader. And these are the following activity which a leader should do or to ensure and follow such activities. There are the various styles of leadership. The first one is autocratic, second is participative, third democratic, and fourth laissez-faire. Autocratic. The autocratic imposes their own decision with other without explanation to a subordinate, who just imposes it that this particular work has to be done. So that is known as that leadership is known as the autocratic. The second one is the participative, where everybody is participating. The decision made after prior consultation with the subordinates, where everybody is participating and they are involving or his or her points. Democratic. Democratic are those where a joint decision arrived at a similar time, or when if everybody is been speaking and there is a joint decision which has been taken care of. So that is known as a democratic. And the last one is laissez-faire. This is a decision which a delegation is made. The decision which is made by the delegation, that is known as the laissez-faire. So this was all about teamwork and leadership. Thank you so much.